Now, children, as you are now aware of some of the operations between sets like union, intersection, and difference of sets, we are ready to define another term which is complement of a set. You must have done this, gone through this term complement in probability in class 10th. Let us see how complement of a set is defined. Is it very much like that only or not? Okay. See, I have defined it here. It says if A is any set and U is the universal set for it, then complement of set A, which can be denoted as A with a bar or A with a dash here, or it can be A with a superscript C for complement. So, complement of a set A will be a new set which will be consisting of all the elements of U. That means all the elements of universal set which do not belong to the set A. That means element will be there in the universal set, but it will be out of A. So you can understand this better with Venn diagram. See, this box is a universal set and A is subset of that. So A is inside the universal set. Now if you define complement of A now, then according to the definition, complement of A will contain that element of universal set which is not coming inside this set A. So you can easily see this dotted portion which is outside A is that portion where the elements are part of U but they are not part of A. So this portion is the complement of A. See, in set builder form how it can be written. A complement will contain elements X such that X belongs to U and X does not belongs to A. You try to relate it, this definition with the difference of two sets, you will find it resembles it. See, when I say A minus B, it means the element belongs to A, but it does not belongs to B. And we wrote it as A minus B. So here also same thing is happening. X is an element which is in the set U and it is not in A. So A complement can be written as U minus A. That means from the entire universal set, you remove the elements of A. So the leftover is A complement. Okay, now let us attempt some questions based on the definitions we have done till now. These are some questions from the exercise. The first one says, find the union of the following sets. We'll quickly recall the definition. For union of two sets, we define a new set which includes the elements of both the sets. So A is having elements A, E, I, O, U. B is having element A, B, C. We have to define their union. So A union B will contain those elements which belong to A or which belong to B. They can belong to both also. If they are belonging to both, we will write it only once. Like you see, A is in both the sets. So A will come definitely. Then B, C will come, A, E, I, O, U. So each element of A as well as B. It was only A which was appearing in both. So we wrote it only once. Then see the next one. This is in set builder form. Set A denotes elements X where nature of X is N. That means it is a natural number and it is strictly greater than 1. That means X cannot be 1. It is a natural number greater than 1. But it is less than equal to 6. So it can be 6 or less than 6. So if I try to write it in roster form, X will take these values 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So X can be any of these numbers for set A. Moving on to set B. Again, B is containing natural numbers which are strictly greater than 6 and strictly less than 10. So more than 6 but less than 10. That means X can take values 7, 8, 9. We have to write union of these two. So if I combine these two things, these two things, you will find X is greater than 1, it is less than equal to 6, it is equal to 6 also. Then B is containing numbers greater than 6 but less than 10. It is easy for you to visualize it from here. If I write union of these two, we will get all these numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, which can be written as A union B is having elements X where X is a natural number and X is strictly greater than 1 and it is strictly less than 10. Means it is a natural number greater than 1 but less than 9. So you are going to get all these 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You can also write it as x is greater than equal to 2 but less than equal to 9. That can also be written. Now coming to the third one, it says if A and B are two sets such that A is a subset of B, then what is A union B? See, A is proper subset of B. I'll show you through Venn diagram. Suppose this is B and this is A. So this shows A is proper subset of B. You can see A is entirely in the set B, completely contained in it. Now if I take their union, union means all the elements of A as well as all the elements of B. So I will take all the elements which are coming here, we will take these elements also. Okay, so B contains the elements of A also. So when you will take the union of both, you will see finally it will come out to be set B only. Now moving on to question number 4, you can see I have written 4 sets over here. Using these sets, we will be defining some of the operations between the sets. So randomly I will take some questions, like say we have to define B union C. So we'll quickly look at the sets and define the union. B union C means all the elements of B as well as all the elements of C. When I start writing for B, we have numbers 3, 4, 5, 6. Then moving on to C, 5 and 6 are belonging to C, which are already written, so we'll not write it again. We'll move on to the next element. So it becomes 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. This will be in the union of B and C. Suppose we take 3 sets, A union B union D. So you can solve it by taking 2, 2 sets at a time. I can write it as A union B, and then we can take its union with D. So let us write the union of A and B. Look at set A and B. So A union B will contain all the elements of A as well as all the elements of B. So that gives us 1, 2, 3, 4. When we move on to B, these are also in B, so we'll write it only once. Then 5, 6. Now I have to take its union with the set D, which is having elements 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, union of these two will be all the elements of both the sets. So if I combine all the elements, we get natural numbers from 1 to 10. Okay, see, you have to be very careful every time what brackets you are using. For sets, you will use these braces only, strictly these braces. Okay. Now let us try to define something else. Say we have to find A intersection C. Let us try to apply the definition intersection on it. So A intersection D, if we try to find, we will see what are the elements common to A and D. You look at the set A intersection C we are taking, sorry. A is having elements 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to take its intersection with C, which is having element 5, 6, 7, 8. So, as per the definition of intersection of sets, it will contain only those elements which are common to both, which are in A as well as in C. Compare these two sets, we don't find any element which are in set A as well as in set B. So, the intersection of these two will be a null set. Okay. Fine. Then let us define. Okay, if we go for finding, say, A intersection B, and then I take its intersection with D, suppose. So, we can take intersection of A and B, whatever we will get, then we will take its intersection with D. So, you quickly see, do we have something in the intersection of A and B? Look at this. This is set A, that is set B. So, for the intersection of A and B, we need the elements common to A as well as B. Okay, let us see what will come in the intersection of these two. You will find 3 and 4 are the numbers which are common to A and B. So, this is A intersection B. Taking intersection of D with it. D is having elements 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, if I define the intersection now, look at these terms. You will not find any element common among them. So, this intersection comes out to be 0. Okay. Then, moving on to the third definition we used, that was of difference of two sets. Okay. Let us take some examples based on difference of two sets. Using, let us say, this question only. Say you have to find A minus B. So, what is set A? Set A is having elements 1, 2, 3, 4. Then minus set B is having elements 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, difference of sets is a new set which contains all the elements of first set, but it should not be in the second set. So, you have to see in this first set, is there any element of B? If yes, then you are not going to write. So, in A minus B, I will only get those elements of A which are not in B. So, we will move from one element to another. First, we will write for 1. Is 1 present in A? B, it is not there. It is only in A. So, we will write it in A minus B. Then, we move on to 2. 2 is present in A, but it is not in B. So, the next term will be 2. Then, moving on to 3. 3 is an element of A, but it is also an element of B. So, you are not going to write 3. In the same way, 4. 4 is an element of A, but it is element of B also. So, that can also, we cannot write. So, A minus B will contain only 1 minus 2. Only those elements of A which are not in B. Okay, let us take another example. Say, I have to write B minus D. So, from B, you subtract D. B is having elements 3, 4, 5, 6. And D is having elements 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the resulting set will be containing those elements of B which are not in D. Okay, let us start from the elements of B. 3 is an element of B and it is not in D. So, we can write 3. 4 is an element of B, but it is not in D. We can write 4 also. 5 is belonging to B, but it is not belonging to D. So, you can write 5 as well. Then 6 belongs to B, but it does not belong to D. So, we can write 6 also. So, we are getting the entire B because they were disjoint sets. They were not having anything in common. Okay. So, all the elements of B could be written here. So, these are some examples to understand how to write union, intersection and difference of two sets. In the next session, we will do more questions based on these operations.